everybody. This is Praxis, and today I'm working on the grout work around the tile above the bathtub shower area. It's a little bit meticulous because I'm just taking tiny little spatulas, or whatever this thing's called, of grout and trying to push it into these cracks. It's always easier when it's the floor because, you know, gravity is helping you. But, you know, I'm doing little bits at a time, and I'm managing to get it in there pretty well. I'm trying to really pack these things full because it'll just help to further stabilize the tile, and I definitely don't want any voids down at the bottom where water could kind of get in there, you know, if we get a little puddle here and there. The grout that I'm using is the same grout that I used for the floor down there. Actually, it's the same type of tile as well. And I should mention, if you're ever going to be using grout that you haven't used for a while, if it's been sitting around, it's really good to do a test. Now, manufacturers are always going to say, you know, if the grout's been sitting around for X number of months, you should throw it out and, you know, buy more from them. Of course, they have a financial incentive to say that, so, you know, you get a question about how accurate that is. But if you're not sure about how accurate it is, do a test. Mix them up. Let it sit. Make sure that the stuff actually is going to cure and set and harden, because you know, I have had experiences where I used some grout that was a few years old and it was just essentially powder. You know, you mix it up, kind of hardens a little bit, but you know, you scrape it and it's, you know, just coming apart. It's essentially useless stuff. So if you are going to be using some old grout, make sure you do run a test on it. One other thing that I wanted to mention, since we're doing this video today, is that another aspect of the house, which was kind of experimental and was done, I guess, on spec, you'd say, is working really, really well. And that is the greenhouse at this point is heating our house. Outside, it's, you know, 30 degrees, 40 degrees today. It's been like that. You know, for a couple of days. We had a couple of warm days in there too, but I'm finding that as long as it's sunny out and at least 45 degrees, the western greenhouse gets to be about 80, 85 degrees. We open up the window in this bathroom, we open up the door downstairs, and we're cycling that heat into the house. That trickles up to the top floor where it gets captured and then pumped down under the slab, and we are heating our slab to keep the house warm throughout the night by doing that. And we haven't had a fire, which is our, you know, only source of heat outside of the sun. We haven't had a fire in about a week, and that's a real success. You know, when I set up this house, I hoped that it could subsist on some solar heating. We were prevented from using the real solar gain windows on the house itself, again, ironically, by the environmental energy rules of the state, but those rules didn't apply to the greenhouse. That greenhouse is allowed to capture all that solar heat, and it's really working out for us. We've saved a lot of effort of not having to, you know, lug wood in and, you know, do fires. Not that it's that big of a deal, but we haven't had to do that. If we were buying that wood, we would have saved that money. And, you know, I don't buy the wood. I just cut it off the land here, but I save all the time and the effort having to do that. So the sun is making heating our house at this point really easy. So I'm thinking the only time we're really going to have to heat the house is just dead of winter. And then, you know, fall and spring, we're going to be able to heat it completely just off the solar energy from the greenhouse. And obviously summer, we don't have to heat it at all. So that's how things are going. I'm just going to finish up this work. I got the threshold down there. I'm going to do a little grout down over there by the threshold. You know, little by little, little parts of the house are coming together, making it feel more and more finished every day. That's it. Thanks for watching.